Good evening, Zimbabwe. You are listening to Studio 7 from the Voice of America on Wednesday, August 12th, 2015. And this is LiveTalk. I am Kip Stube.
And I'm Jonga Kandemiri.
Tonight on LiveTalk, we are talking about massive job cuts in Zimbabwe.
To join our discussion, phone us directly at 001-202-619-2077 and we'll call you back.
LiveTalk goes out to Zimbabwe on our 909 meter wave frequency and on the 4930-5940 and 15455 kilo shortwave Monday through Friday at 8:30 p.m.
On the internet, you can find us at www.voazimbabwe.com, at www.voashona.com, and at www.ndebele.com.
Thanks for joining us once again. Tonight on Studio 7 Live Talk, we are talking about job losses in Zimbabwe.
The state-controlled ZBC, or Zimbabwe Broadcasting Corporation, today fired close to 300 workers, including journalists, and also shut down its Gweru offices. The Zimbabwe Newspapers Group has already fired hundreds of workers.
Newsday and Daily News have also fired dozens of employees in the past few days.
About 20,000 workers have been sent home following a Supreme Court ruling allowing employers to sack workers by only giving them a three-month notice.
What are your views on this issue? If you wish to join the show right now, phone us directly at this number, 001-202-619-2077, and we'll call you back. That number again, 001-202-619-2077.
You can also send us a message on WhatsApp. Our number is 001-202-465-0318, or post the messages on Twitter, Facebook, or email at studio7news@voanews.com.
Ibambe mahlabezulu lingalithola njani lapho likhona thina ngapha lojonga sibona ngazani siyaphila mfowethu kunjalo.
Andirumpenyu.
Ehe.
Asi andizuyanyo simba kana vamwe vachirasikirwa nemabasa.
Kunzima mfowethu ulahlekelwa umsebenzi yazi into ebuhlungu kakhulu. Uyakwazi abantwana bavengasela ukudla la ungasenelisa ukuthi usigcine. So ke sizwile khona ngale ZBC sebekhipha abantu 300. Abantu abaningi kakhulu incaso buya lezi papers lakho 280 kumbe some khonapho ke. Kuzobuya ke abantu abaningi 20,000 sebelahlekelwe yimsebenzi. Lokhu kulandela isinqumo esathathwa yi Supreme Court eyathi umqhaji ulakho ukuthi axotshe isebenzi. Abe sesinika kuphela 3 months ukuthi hayi indoda kumbe mama Chapans. So ngani kuzima kakhulu abamfowethu.
Ndizvozvo ingwe yakava magips tikutarisa kuti munyika manga mune vanhu vagara vasina mabasa nechekare. Tinonzwa kuti kubva pakapiwa mutongo we Supreme Court vanhu vanodarika 20,000 varasikirwa nemabasa. Nasi tanzwa kuti ZBC ya pawo zviziviso zvekuti vamiswe mabasa vashandi vanoda kusvika kuma 300. Mapepa nawo mamwe akaitawo se Daily News, Zim Papers vakamisawo vashandi vanosanganisira vatori venhawo mabasa. Nyaya yapo ndeyekuti vana veZimbabwe vachawana kupi nhau kana mapepa nepfenyuro vanotarisirwa kunge vachipa nhau idzi kumhuri yeZimbabwe. Variwe wari kutomisa vashandi basa. Ndo nyaya tiri kuti kurukure Gibbs.
Joining us tonight to discuss this issue is Mr. Foster Tongozi, who is the Secretary General of the Zimbabwe Union of Journalists. Mr. Tongozi, good evening and welcome to the program.
Thank you very much. It's not a good evening. I'm surprised you think it's a good evening.
Not at all. So it's a very sad evening, actually.
Right.
Yes. So tell us what is going on in the media circles, you know?
Yeah, there is absolute chaos. There is pandemonium. There is a senselessness, particularly when you consider that a lot of Zimbabweans, and I'm speaking on behalf of journalists and media workers, are left stranded with no jobs, essentially. That essentially affects their livelihoods. And given the kind of economic environment, one wonders what then needs to be done or what is the way forward.
Hey, Choga.
Asi se sanganu re vatorwe nhau kana kuti rinomirira nyadzi kufambiswa kwenhau mune zvamakamboedza rukuita kuti vashandi vange vachichengetedzwawo mabasa tinonzwa na ZCTV nemaya masangano vari kurwisawo zvikuru.
Aiwa zvatikona ndezvekuti zvo is now class 5 yekuti avo vane mari kana kuti vanoshandirwa vashandirwi ndova kugadzirisa mangwana yavo vasina nehanya yokuti vashandi voitwa sei. Tinove chinhu tinoshamisa kana tinohlisa chaizvo zvikurusisa kana takatarisa kuti isusu kubva kana gore makore hondo chaizvo zvaingonzi workers and peasants zvichireva kuti varimi vekumamisha nevashandi ndo vaifanirwa kupindira pakurwisa muvengi pakuunza rusununguko rwenyika.
Ye masuka kene kuno kuchoni baba tongozi ngoba kukanya ngazani sibili kuyababa loko
kuyababa sibili kodwa into engiyinanzelelayo ngeyokuthi yona izisebenzi njengezisebenzi kuningi ongenzakala njengoba libone abanye betshengisela kodwa ukutshengisela ambone ukuthi kungaletha inguquko ekhona. Abanye bathi bona hhayi njengoba sesikhangelane lokuguquka singathi kwe-industry yokuqhutshwa kwembiko njalo sesikhangelane labo-digitalization sokumele kubonwe kumbe kuhlolwe ukuthi intatheli zindaba lezi zingangena njani kumbe ziphatheke njani kuhlelo lwe-digitalization lolo olukhangelelwe ukuthi lulethe amathuba okuqhatshwa kwezisebenzi kakhulu ezibona ngokuqhutshwa kwembiko kuhlelo kumbe kuhlangothi lwama-TV ngoba nxa sikhangelane le-digitalization program kuzaphuma ngathi imisakazo eminingi phose mbe elishumi lambili eyokuthi abantu baqhube mbe bahambise imbiko. Ngakho-ke sokukhangelane lathi ukuthi sibone ukuthi singakhuthaza njani ukuthi intatheli zindaba zifunde kakutsha imisebenzi yokuthi ziqhube imbiko kodwa zikhangelane lokusakaza ikakhulu ku-TV nakuradio njengoba lihlazi ngaphansi kohlelo le-digitalization kuzaphuma phose ama-television station amanenganyana nama-radio station.
Kodwa
singazi ukuthi ngaphansi kohlelo lokunikwa incwadi zokuthi abantu baqhube lolo hlelo olokusakaza kwabe sokuzakhangelwa sibone ukuthi abayebezanikwa lezo ncwadi mbe imvumo yokuthi basakaze bangakwenelisa na.
Siyakuzwa kakhulu ke ubambe khonapho ungayikhatshana. So what Mr. Tongozi was saying is that you know there's this digitalization process that is actually going on. He says most probably journalists can benefit out of it and they should find ways maybe for them to benefit. But he says the big question is licensing in Zimbabwe is a big challenge, issue. Yes. So now we are joined by two other guests, and the second one is Mr. Washington Metlo Makulu. He's an independent political and economic commentator, and also Mr. James Maridade, who is a member of parliament and former ZBC employee. So we'll start with you, Mr. Metlo Makulu, first. Go for him.
Mr. Metlo Makulu, looking at the current economic situation and where the future is headed, what's your take on these continued layoffs?
Well, the layoffs that we have witnessed in the past 2 to 3 weeks are an indication of the economic situation, the economic crisis that we find ourselves in. And what has now happened is that workers have become collateral damage in the process. And you must also understand that employers are not simply firing workers willy-nilly, but a response to what is happening within private enterprise. If you notice that since the beginning of the year, we have had a number of companies that have been placed under judicial management. And one of the major costs that sticks out is that the cost of labor. And we foresee that we will see additional layoffs in the coming weeks until that that loophole is closed through the amended Labour Act that the government is trying to pass through Parliament.
Mm-hmm. So now let's go to you, Mr. Maridade. Welcome to the program. Are you there, Mr. Maridade?
Yes, I can hear you.
Right. What is your take on what is going on? You know, ZBC, Zim Papers, you know, all over the show. People are being just fired, you know?
Yeah, but look, this is how the economy is performing. Mm. You cannot look at people being fired in isolation of what is happening in the greater economy. I think we must have a global picture of what is happening in the economy. Mm. The economy is stagnated. It is not performing. It has taken a tailspin, and this is the result of what is happening in the economy. I mean, the fact that the labor laws allow this to be done the way it is being done mm-hmm. is neither here nor there. The fact of the matter is that companies are choking because they are not able to pay salaries. So because of the economic condition, the state of the economy. So, I mean, that's why the company will lay off people. I mean, this is what was said ever since 1999, that the ZANU-PF is not capable of running this economy. Mm-hmm. They must just simply do the right thing. They must just resign and allow people that are able to run the economy, run the economy.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, and stay on the line. I think Mr. Matlumakulu and Mr. Maridade are saying almost the same thing, you know? Mm-hmm.
Yes,
they're saying it's because of the economy, yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's the global picture.
That's true.
Yes, so I think we've got a caller, right?
Yes, we have Mukoma General E. Magadi.
Ndivo Magadi zvei.
Ndakasimba, tiri kukurukura nevari muchiuto here, ndi general avo.
Ndi general vakazvimirira.
Aiwa ndizvozvo. General, tibatsirei tikurukure nyaya iri mudariro. Nyaya iri kuchemwa neruzhinji rwenyika. Nyika yagara yange nevanhu vainzi vaipfuura 80% vanga vachizviitira mabasa emaoko. Zvino pamusoro paivavo tirikunzwa kuti mukati mesvondo nhatu chete vanodarika zviuru makumi maviri varasikirwa nemabasa. More than 20,000. Munoti?
Ndinotenda mukoma Jonga. Maonera andinoita inini panhau yakaita seiyoyo. Ndoda kuti vanhu vazhinji vazive kuti hurumende iri kutitungamirira munyika iyi ihurumende yakapinda pachigaro kare kare zvinoratidza kuti magariro ayaita muhurumende ichitungamirira nyika zvinopa pachena kuti hapana pundiso ingawanikwa nemunhu wese muZimbabwe kana vachipromisa vanhu mabasa 2 million jobs pamusoro pezvo vanhu votanga kudzingwa mabasa zvinotaridza kukundikana kwehurumende kukundikana kutungamirira nyika kuti zvinhu zvigadzikane vanhu vaende mumabasa vatange kusevenza vasevenzere mhuri dzavo saka ini maonero andinoita ndeyekuti dai zvaikwanisika dai mitemo isingatorwi ichiiswa muhomwe zvaya zvakanaka kuti vashandi vange vachiratidzira nyunyiko yavo kuhurumende kuratidza kuti zviri kuitwa nehurumende kana kunamirira akaita zvinhu munyika haana kumira zvakanaka saka inini maonero andinoitawo ndine tarisiro yekuti dai vanopikisana neutongi hwehurumende iripo vaitaura nezi rimwe chete vakabatana voratidza kuti varipo nekutungamirira kuti vanhu vese vabatani vachitaura nezi rimwe chete kuti zviri kuitika munyika hazvina kwatiri kuenda nehurumende iripo iyoyi saka ndo maonero andinoita iyi ndaive netarisiro yekuti dai zvagadziriswa nemunhu wese zvake pane maonero akafanana neiwa yayo
saka zvama muchitaura mukomata zvinzwa asi imi muri mushandi here zvii zvamuri kuitawo semushandi kana muchiri pamabasa kukurudziranawo nevamwe vari kurasikirwa nemabasa iva
ndimumwewo ndanga ndiri mushandiwo ndakatorasikirwawo nebasa saka takangofanana takawanda takarasikirwa nemabasa iwayo saka izvozvii kuti ukwanise kuti urarame nemamiriro akaita upfumi hwenyika ino iye zvino kurarama kwacho kuri kutonetsa kuti ukwanise kuwana rimwe basa zvakatooma hakuna kwaunoriwana saka tarisiro yedu yanga iri pakuti hurumende zvayakanga yatiyo yazvipinza pachigaro muna 2013 maelection ngaichiita zvayakazvipinza pachigaro kwacho ndo marizauti atiri kuona iwayayo
thank you so much mukoma maita basa mukoma general he's saying that taurai tinzwe mukoma
ndinotenda zvizhinji mukoma jonga ndaive neshungu chaizvo kuti ndipindewo pasudio sedzandaisiyo ndinodaira kuti mucharambawo muchindidaidzawo ndichipindawo ndichicontributawo zvinofanirwa kuti dai zvagadzirisika munyika yedu semararamiro atiri kuita akaoma kudai.
Aiwa, maita basa mukoma, muri dunhu ripi kana makasununga yanyu kuti taurirwa kuti muri dunhu ripi?
Ndiri muno muHarare nemuno.
Muri muHarare, aiwa maita basa mukoma general.
Nendo muve nenguva yakanaka.
Thank you. He's saying I think during elections ZANU-PF promised 2 million jobs and instead what people are getting is job losses, not job creation. So he's urging the opposition parties to at least unite on this cause and fight as one voice to make sure that workers are protected. And I think Maridadi is one of the opposition people in the in parliament, and I heard what this caller said. Maybe we'll give him a chance later to respond to that.
Now, let's get back to Mr. Dongozi. I think you are still on the line. Are you there?
Yes, sir, I'm calling.
Right, Mr. Dongozi, you heard Mr. Mahlomakulu and Mr. Maridadi saying all this is because of, you know, the economy. The economy is not performing well. We can think of, you know, the digitalization program, all those things. But nothing may work because the economy is almost collapsing. So what is your reaction to that?
Well, one thing for sure is that if people are able to create good content, whether it's television or radio, people will be able to sustain themselves. There are a lot of organizations. There will be a lot of competition for good content. But however, back to the economy, it is true partly in the sense that the employers, and by employers I mean government, because government is an employer, are faced with a situation whereby do they sustain jobs that do not generate income, or do they just sustain jobs, say in the case of the NRZ, where people have been unpaid for the past 2 or 3 years, I don't know how long that is, which may actually ultimately result in the closure or collapse of the company, of the companies affected. And therefore, you have a case 22 situation whereby the economy certainly plays a role in that. But that's not to say those in business or the employers were not aware of what was happening or developing. We warned about this so many years, I should say, ago, when organizations, particularly media organizations, started staggering salaries, started reducing allowances and doing all sorts of chicaneries. And that, for me, then starts talking to issues of business models. What sort of business models are we pursuing in Zimbabwe, given the kind of economic environment that we have? Certainly, you, Gibbs, I remember during the time that you were a journalist in Zimbabwe, you would find that, say, for an assignment, there would be the journalist, there would be the driver, there would be the photographer, and so on. And this has been allowed to continue without people being taught the requisite skills. So, for example, when issues to do with going on assignment are brought up, you find that people have to be taught how to multi-skill. In this day and age, you can be having a driver and a photographer, and so that's what I was talking about. That people then have to be taught skills to say, I can do most, if not all, the things that are required while going on assignment. Just a quick example. Many years ago, we used to have meter readers or something like that. But obviously, that has gone away with technology and stuff like that. And so, therefore, that speaks a lot to the foolishness or failure to adapt by business and government as employers in this environment where they are changing technology. So, certainly,
yeah. 10 seconds.
Yeah.
In just 10 seconds, wrap up. Yes. You can say your 10 seconds, last words there.
Yeah, this is just madness. And it's a class war, it's a class situation, which is why, for example, you find government and employers agreeing for the first time in in one of the few times, you know, government and employers are agreeing. That's nonsense.
Yeah, thank you so
much, Mr. Stay on the line. Well, he's talking about technology and all that, but in most developed countries, that technology is also costing workers their jobs.
The internet.
We'll come back to that.
Yeah.
Tina Rumbidzai, variku Zimbabwe, makadi.
Tibet, makadiyo.
Ndimai, ndimuzvare, ndiani hamu?
Ya, ndinozi Rumbidzai, maunde.
Ndimuzvare, aiwa maita basa, mapinda bachirongwa. Muda kusarudza rurimi rwupi, chirungu kana chizezuru?
Ndotaura nechishona zvangu kuti ndinyatsoburike mapoints angu zvakanaka.
Taurai tinzwe.
Inini ndiri kuona kuti nyaya yekuti vanhu vari kushaya mabasa kwavari kuita zviri kukonzera especially vanasikana vedu vanenge vadzingwa mabasa kuti vazoenda kuchihure ende izvi chihure zvacho zvinenge zvichikonzeresa HIV and AIDS. Zvandiri kutaura izvi zviri kutoitika kwandiri kugara. And the other thing zviri kukonzeresa domestic violence. Baba vanenge vadzingwa kubasa kwavadzingwa uku vakuya vakupedzera stress dzose pamukadzi nekuti havakuziva kuti havachakwanisi kusupporta the family and the kids. Saka I really think kuti something must be done panyaya dzevanhu vari kudzingwa mabasa because kana wadzinga baba woraitiko mwana wechikoro ada kuenda kuchikoro renti da kubhadharwa inini mukadzi ndichararama nei nekuti baba ndovanga vachitibatsira. Saka zvakutotikonzeresa kuti inini nababa tigare tichirovana each and every day. Takuroverana nyaya dzisina nebasa rese. We are causing domestic violence of which that is not right. We should have at least there should be something chinota kuti tigare tiri vanhu vanogara zvakanaka. But kana pasisina chekuti baba vanorarama nacho amai I can survive. Zvakutongoreva kuti tese tava kutoparara.
Yeah, thank you so much. That's a very good observation, hanzvadzi yamaita yekuti mumba makashayika chekubata kazhinji munoitwa mhirizhonga violence, domestic violence inokwira.
Yes, and the other thing zvakutokonzeresa kuti mabasa acho handi hakuna isu vanasikana vedu they are not forced to get into marriages at not my early marriages because vakuti kumba kwedu kurufana kunge kune chikafu saka ndikatororwa zvangu kazvitori nani ndirorwe ndarorwa inini I can support the family. Saka tatova neissue yeearly marriage yatove ipapa nyaya dzekushayikwa mabasa dzakutokonzeresa maearly marriages of which that is not right. Mwana musikana ane right yekumboprocedawo nelife yake achiita something but because of nyaya yekushayikwa kwemabasa is forced kunge atopinda marriage iri unplanned.
Thank you so much maita basa hanzvadzi.
Thank you so much.
Okay, I think we can go to Misty.
Oh, maybe before that, we are told that Foster Tongos wants to go.
Oh, okay.
We had promised that only 5 minutes and then you'd leave.
That's okay.
So, Mr. Tongos, are you on the line? We are told by our producer that he has actually jumped into his car. He's on his way to Harare.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, thank you so much, Mr. Tongos. I know that you are listening right now and you are on your way to Harare. Thank you. Thank you so much. So, proceed with the caller.
Yeah, I was done with the caller, but you have another caller before I go to Mr. Maridad.
Yes, or maybe what we can do, let's go first to Mr. Metlo Makulu, and then we go to Mr. James Maridad, and then a caller.
The caller.
We hold him a little bit.
Okay.
So, Mr. Metlo Makulu, you heard people saying that, you know, they agree with you, the economy has got a problem. And Mr. Maridad says the real problem is ZANU-PF. You know, ZANU-PF is sticking too much to power, and it's doing nothing. 2 million jobs. I know where to be found. Your reaction to that, 1 minute.
Well, I think it again boils down to the economy, irrespective of who the architect of the problem is. If you look at the public sector in particular, if you look at what transpired in Air Zimbabwe and the National Railways of Zimbabwe, which also suffered job losses in the past week, recall that Air Zimbabwe was not operating for a number of months. There was not a single Air Zimbabwe flight in the air. So Zimbabwe was not generating income, but at the same time, Zimbabwe was employing close to 1,000, if not more, employees that continued to be on their payroll. Mm. And the salary obligations continue to accrue to Zimbabwe. If you look at National Railways, it's the same situation in terms of there's very few goods and services that are being that are moving on our rail. Mm. And you also see this in across the spectrum in terms of the public sector. And there was also need in this particular, especially in the public sector, mm. to realign the staff levels to the realities on the ground, to the financial and economic realities that are obtaining within this particular sector. So mm. there was need to do that. But what prevented that from happening was the inflexibility in our labor laws to allow restructuring that. Unfortunately, and this is not what people want. Unfortunately, it might lead to job losses, and that's what we are seeing. And what the private sector has also done is that a number of private sector companies mm-hmm. have found themselves in this particular situation, and they've taken advantage of the court ruling to then try to right size and try to restructure their balance mm-hmm. and be able to move forward.
Thank you very much, Mr. Maradade. Your reaction to that? So it's shifting the blame to other people, not ZANU-PF. Your action, please.
Well, I think, look, ZANU-PF is running the government, mm-hmm. and ZANU-PF presented us with a manifesto before the elections in 2013, mm-hmm. which promised 2 million jobs. The conditions that existed politically, the conditions that existed in terms of the economy, mm-hmm. and the conditions that existed in terms of international relations are the same. What mm-hmm. has changed now? I think people of Zimbabwe reserve the right to take this government to court, and they win in court. Because you promised 2 million jobs, but what you are doing now is dismissing people from jobs. I think we could talk about people being dismissed and everything else until we turn blue in the face, until the cows come home. But the fact of the matter remains, President Mugabe is unable to run this country. He's unable to run an economy. He's unable to run a modern economy, a modern state, and he must do the right thing. At 91, he has had his run, he's tired, he must go. That is the most, that's the only sensible thing to do. I think what we're doing here is that we're dealing with symptoms. Let's go to the root cause of the problem. The root cause of the problem is a 91-year-old man who is not able to run a country. That is the root cause of the problem. We can talk about everything else. We can talk about everything else. As long as President Mugabe remains the constant, but everything else ever since 1980 has changed. Ministers have changed. Government departments have changed. Political parties have changed. Opposition parties have changed. We have remained with one constant, the president. And his name is Robert Mugabe. What it means is that he must do the right thing and say, gentlemen, here I am. I'm unable to run this modern economy. I'm unable to transform this economy. And please, let me pass on the baton to somebody else. It could be even the president from ZANU-PF. It could be somebody from the streets. I'm not worried about who takes over. As long as it is somebody else, and whoever it is, he will not be as bad as it is now. I mean, that's my take. I will not talk about anything else. I will not talk about the law. I will not talk about the economy. I will talk about the leadership. Because what happens in the country is a reaction to the leadership policies. It's a reaction to policies that are put in place by the ruling party. And the policies that are put in place by the ruling party are emanating from the person in charge of that party. The person in charge of the party is President Mugabe.
So 10 seconds, Mr. Maradade.
Everything that is happening in this country, the blame should be put squarely, they should rest squarely on the shoulders of the person who is running this country.
Thank you very much. Yes, thank you. Yes. Thank you very much, and stay on the line. So I think we are as well along for it. Mm-hmm. President, ukhona phuhlezi yikho ngani kule nkinga khona.
Yes.
Siyabuyela futhi Baba Mlondo khona ngapho eBotswana, lawe Baba Desire khona ngapho South Africa. Bambana ucingo sibilinga ikhatshana. So we wish to say goodbye to our radio listeners as we are now streaming live at www.voazimbabwe.com. For our guests, Mr. Washington Mehlo Makhulu and Mr. James Maradade, please stay on the line. Do you have a caller there?
No, we don't have a caller, but we just make sure that we urge them to continue calling, even though we are now streaming live.
That's right. So this is Gibbs Dube in Washington, D.C. Stay tuned.
And Abjonga Kandemiri.
If you have just joined us tonight on Studio 7 Live Talk, we are talking about massive job cuts in Zimbabwe. We heard that the ZBC today retrenched or fired about 300 workers. And before that, Jonga, Zimpapers had also fired more than 280 people.
Yes.
So at the end of the day, some of them are journalists, some general laborers, and some in the printing departments, and so forth. And in Zimbabwe generally, 20,000 people have actually lost their jobs following that Supreme Court ruling that employers can terminate employees' jobs, you know, after giving them
three months.
Notice. Yes. So our guests tonight are Mr. Washington Metlomakulu, who is an independent political and economic commentator, and Mr. James Maridade, who is a lawmaker. Yeah, as coming forward.
I think we have two callers there.
Yes.
You can start with the callers first, then
right.
We'll go to our guests.
Yes, before going to the callers, shortly we'll just rush to them, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let me read something on Facebook.
Okay.
Now, on Facebook, we've got a message from a Kenyan who says, "This is a moment of madness in Zimbabwe." Then we've got Makwena who says, "This ruling is terrible because many people who lose jobs are breadwinners.
Mm-hmm.
Hence, life is going to be very hard for their families." Then we've got another message from Jeremiah, who says, "Something is very wrong in Zimbabwe. We cannot think of what is happening because all this is about human errors." So people are really not happy there, right?
That's true.
Do you have anything on WhatsApp?
Yes, we have Mukoma Abraham, Vanyorane Chizezuru. Anzi zvimwe zvacho unotoona kuti urongwa ndewe hurumende hwekutapudza vashande vayo vayanga yakapa mabasa mune zvematongerwo enyika. Semuenzaniso, ZBC nepfenyero yeZANU-PF inomirira zvido zveZANU-PF. Koya Sizondo atine chirungu, "I am sure by the time the labor law is amended, there won't be any workers left. The government seems not too keen to stop the carnage." Then AD says, "The Zimbabwe government will not stop to abuse the workers' rights and human rights." And tina mukoma muhlanga vatichiti koichino kashikamadza kwazvo. Izvi zviri kubudisa pachena kukundikana kwehurumende yeZANU-PF. Dai ZANU-PF yaibvuma kuti yatadza kutonga, yorega vana veZimbabwe. Uku kushungurudza vashandi kana munhu achidzingwa ane 30 years pabasa. Ungoenda kumba asina chinhu zvinoreve izvi. Ndiyo here black empowerment iyi? Ivo vamugabe zvavane 35 years vachitonga, indava vasingambomiswiwo basa, zvinonyadzisa izvi. Munyori uyu.
Bakiti, kunze bange foit. Let's go to umnumzana umlondo ose Botswana. Baba Mlondo, ungaunjani?
Sawona tuli.
Ye, kunjani foit?
Hayi, kuyabile kuyazenzela kukhala ngokugijima ngomhlanje.
Ye, kunjalo ke mfowethu. Nxa ngikubingelela ngesiTswana kumele ngithini ke njani? Tumelang, dat.
Yeah,
likai
mre.
So kubeka baba sis.
Right, yazi mina lapha mangaliswa into ukuthi i Supreme Court sure ingavumela into enjalo. Abantu be labor bangapi futhi? Lako bakuvuma into enjalo. Usebenze pho yazi ungakubhekisisa kuhle. Into abantu labo bona labo sebeqotshwa ngabantu ababhinsela ukusebenza bangeholi, abanye babengaholi for 2 years, abanye abaholanga iminyaka ethile bezama ukukhuphula izinto. Abantu be-government bazama ukubuya to the lowest figure, 150. Kodwa namhla ibo sebeqotshwa njengeqotha umsumvundla yaphi yancitshwa ulutho, yancitshwa ivini lensiba lomoya yabomvundi. Ukuthi really mina into engingayizwisisiyo yi-Supreme Court yakhona. Hayi, nga i-Supreme yakhona injalo kutsho ukuthi phela eZimbabwe i-human rights kayikho. Abantu kabaye ephandle abahle bengena emgwaqweni, there's no human right. Yikho phela into engitshengisana uthi umuntu esebenze 30 years, mina njomna wami osebenze almost 40 years, but ubele 5 years ezama ukuphuma bayala and then namuhla sebemxotsha. You see ukuthi how get kuyakwena ibuthakathi obunjani kona lobo
ngozima baba Mlondo. Ye, siyakuzwa kakhulu sebenzi. Ye, elokugcina baba.
Mina lapha angisakwazi lokubhosile.
Ye, bhosile okugcina. So Mr. Mlondo is saying, where is the labor court or the labor office? So he says, in previous years, you know, the labor office used to play a key role in stopping all these kind of things. Mm-hmm. And we want to inform our listeners and viewers that we actually tried to talk to the Minister of Labor, mm-hmm. but we couldn't get through there.
That's true.
He says most of these people who have actually been fired were at work and they were never paid for a long, long, long time, you know. Mm-hmm. They wanted to change things, but all of a sudden they've been retrenched. So he says he does not understand what this whole Supreme Court ruling is all about. He says it's a bit evilish, you know. Mm-hmm. He doesn't like it. Siyeke kumnumzana uDesire kwele South Africa. Baba Desire kunjani? Ngiyaphila kakhulu. Uyazi ukuthi kudala ngisasenze esikolo ukuphela ibizo elithi Desire kwakuhlupha njani? Ngacina ndikrema ukuthi ndizabhala ngithi Desire. So ke unjani kulapho?
Hayi, ngiyaphila.
Ye, akuphosela kuba.
Hayi, ngizophinde ngisho futhi amagama engangiwasho ukuthi iZimbabwe yaba sebhadini elikhulu ngalesi sikhathi kuthiwa ithole the so-called uzibuse, ngoba uma kuthiwa uzibuse kuyakusho ukuthi abantu bayazibusa bona, like kubusa i-majority, which is not that in Zimbabwe. EZimbabwe kubusa nje uNdlovu ayiphikiswa. Ingakho nomnotho uqhubeka usiwa, kusenzeka into ezihlukene, kuba umrambathinya, kuba yilokhu nalokhu. Always abantu baseZimbabwe kufuna bahlale belinde nje into embi ezokwenzeka ezweni, as long as kusasenalo mbuso okhona. Ngoba lo mbuso ezingisho ngithi kwaba yibhadi nje eZimbabwe ukuthi ma kuthiwa sithathize kulaba abamhlophe liwele kulezi zandla elawela kuzo. Ingakho ntwana abantu beZimbabwe bayohlala bekhala njalo sonke isikhathi, ngoba ayikho into kuthiwa mhlawumbe kulo nyaka eZimbabwe bayacelebrate kwenzeka into enhle, uhulumende wenza into enhle. Angiboni ukuthi ezilonge usaphethele uhulumende kuyokwenzeka lokho, ngoba since lo hulumende waphatha beqala ukuthathize kwakhala njalo nje eZimbabwe, kuhlala kukhalwa ngalokho.
Pho kulungiswa njani mnumzana Desire? Kulungiswe njani?
Le nto angazi noma sekufuna yena uNkulunkulu angenele, or sekufuna bona abantu beZimbabwe ngokubambana sivumelane, sivuleke amehlo, or uNkulunkulu avule amehlo abantu beZimbabwe babone ukuthi inkinga ikuphi, inkinga wokugovernment ophethe. And babe nesibindi la kwamanye amazwe, like into i-revolutionary ayisenzeke South Africa ngesikhathi se-apartheid kubo Soweto. Abantu bame bamele iqiniso, bathi akungasikufa yikuphi, kunokuthi baqhubeke bakhale nje abantu bezenzele umathanda nje ngempilo zabo. Abantwana babo alikho totally ezilongo kusisena lo mbuso kwezamgaba eZimbabwe. Kubuhlungu kakhulu lokho okwenzekayo.
Ye, siyakuzwa kakhulu-ke mnumzana Desire khona ngapho-ke e-South Africa. Ungathinwa lakusasa mnumzana.
Ngathatha ama-second amancane, ngibuze something please.
Kumbe sikufonele singaqeda.
Yeah, please, yeah.
Sizakufonela mnumzana, thank you, eh.
Oh,
yeah, so like what Mr. Mlondo is saying, you know, the problem is with the government, and everything is pointed at the president. He says he has ruled for too long, and, you know, he's not happy about the whole system.
Okay.
So maybe we can go to Metro Makulu and...
Let me go to Mr. Maridadi first, because Mr. Maridadi, we understand that this law has been in place, the labor law has been in place since 1985, if I'm not mistaken. And... it seems like it was silent all along, and now this law has reared its ugly head. As members of parliament, do you have anything to do with this, or can you change it? Because people were looking at the president, and we understand he is not willing to interfere with the rule of law.
No, so listen, I mean, it's nonsensical that the president does not want to interfere with the rule of law. How many times has he interfered with the rule of law? The reason we find ourselves in this situation is because the government does not respect the rule of law. Isn't it what the international community has been crying about, that the Zimbabwean government does not respect the rule of law? You choose to respect the rule of law when it suits you, and you choose to disrespect it when it suits you. How many times is the president threatened judges to say, look, if I see a judge, I want to see that judge is going to preside over that case? How many times have we heard that coming from the president? And now it is a law which is making the people of Zimbabwe suffer. He doesn't want to interfere with it. That is what we call leadership ineptitude.
a good leader will stand up and stand by his people. That is what happens. If it is a law that it should be amended, or even before it is amended, it requires the president to evoke the presidential powers, he must be able to do that. And the president, in this case, he must evoke his presidential powers, because the constitution allows him to do that. And now he doesn't want to interfere with the law because you know, people must get fired from the state enterprises, from ZBC, from ZESA, from Zimbabwe newspapers, and then hide behind this thing and say, I don't want to interfere with the law. I mean, how many times have they interfered with even with court judgments? How many times how many people have we seen that are roaming the streets of Harare today who have been charged with murder, convicted with serious, heinous issues, crimes of during election time? I mean, listen, they have failed, and they must own up. We have failed to run this economy, and gentlemen, it is time for us to go. I mean, it must be that simple.
Thank you very much. Let's go to Mr. Mhlomakulu, your immediate reaction to that. Many people are pointing at the president, you know. They're saying that's where the problem is. Mr. Mhlomakulu? No, I think we've got a very bad line. Yeah. Maybe we've lost him. Let's introduce our next guest, and that is Mr. Bakla Tambo, a policy researcher at the Public Policy Research Institute of Zimbabwe. He's also a lecturer and researcher in the Ministry of Higher Education. Mr. Tambo, good evening and welcome to the program.
Good evening, Gibbs. How are you doing?
No, we're very fine. So, Mr. Tambo, tell us, you are seeing all this kind of bleeding concerning jobs. What is the best way forward here in terms of formulation of policy? You know, people are talking about presidential powers, some are talking about parliament. You know, where should we go here?
I think what we have to understand, Gibbs, is that this is a situation seriously gone wrong. But I think let's be realistic about the situation on the ground, right? What we have is whereby, let's look at companies, maybe some of these parastatals like NRZ. If we want to be very honest, NRZ, the kind of or the amount of goods that they're currently moving, cannot sustain the wage bill that these people have. For instance, in 1992, these people only had one general manager and two deputies. Mm-hmm. And we are speaking, and I think about a workforce of about 12,000 or so, and they were moving 18 million tons of goods a year. Mm-hmm. But look at it this year. This year, I think they are moving nothing more than 3 million tons of goods, and they still have more than 8,000 workers. Obviously, those people need to be shed off. But the problem now is the fact that these people are having to walk away with only 3 months of salary and nothing more. And again, the biggest challenge that we are going to have in the economy is that most of these people are losing their jobs are people who were owing money to most banking institutions. So this is not going to only end with people losing jobs, but it might lead to a banking sector collapse because most of these people took loans, did they mortgages, did they loans against their salaries. And once the salaries don't come in, they will default and banks will have to move in and take over their furniture and the like. And that is going to lead to a real crisis. I think we haven't seen the worst of this situation.
So how then does the government, or maybe those that are stakeholders, formulate policy to actually come out with something to protect the workers?
At the moment, okay, the way I see it, right, I don't think it's an easy situation. It's no longer a 1+1=2 type of arrangement. But I think maybe let's have a real look at the policies, things like maybe the establishment of the special economic zones that government has been talking about. Let's create maybe these, and at least if these are created, they are likely to bring about new employment into areas that did not have any activity anymore. Places like Bulawayo, where deindustrialization is already hit, but then we need a new type of industry coming in. Otherwise, saying that the president can stop the carnage, he stops it, then what? Let's look at some of these people who are losing jobs. These are people who have been going on for 6 months or a year without earning a single cent, and they keep going back to work, hoping that someday they will get something. But that is not bound to happen one way or the other.
Yes, siyabuzwa kakhulu Thambo. Uthi hayi kuyahlupha ukuthi kulungiswe konoko ngoba okuzayenzakala phambilini ukuthi kuyabe sokuvalwa lamabhenki besokubuya nxa ikhangela i-NRZ kudala 1992 yayilo general manager oyi-1 khathesi uyathola omunye echayikhona ngapha omunye echayitiye lapho omunye seza lokhu lalokhu so ukuthi lama-workers mane kakhulu ukuthi uyamanta abanye abantu vele bayenzani. So uthi ke hayi ubona zani ukuthi baxotshwa abanye. Yeah, umele kuhambe njalo.
Asinzira yacho ukuthi vashande vadimurwe ndo iri kuti netsei ndiri kuti navatambo vanga vasingatambire kwemwedzi yakawana. Zvino izvozvo vamwe dzichiendai. Chiri kurangarira takambotaura nevamwe vashande vekumunemwe mugodhi vachiti kubvira 2009 vaenda kubasa zuva roga roga. Ukarova mazuva matatu. Ubva wanzi basa rapera asi hauna chauri kutambiriswa kungoenda kuti uchengete kuti ndinozowana pensheni mumwe musindamiswa basa
kuyabona nxa sikhuluma ngento zokuhola lezi yakumbula si ngo 1980 kwambani wawuzuza inxa ye $600 kumbe ebencane kuthi imali sesizibambile sindla kuzo uthi nxa wawuxotshwa kwambani wawusilwa uthi mina ngiphumi lapha emsebenzini uye kuwekazi comment uchinga kakhulu uyekazi comment katesi sebazi wikena
zvinondo ziri kunzi vamoyo vaJafet Moyo munyori mukuru weZCT iyo takataura nawo zvakaro achitaura kuti dambudziko riripo nderekuti vatungamiri vevamaworkers comment kana kuti vevashandi mumabasa ndovazhinji vevari kutanga kumiswa mumabasa saka vashandi vanosara vasina vanhu vataurira
uyakumbona njalo sikume lomuntu weZBC azozikume bizo
tinzwe ianda achitaura hedu mazita asi pane varamba kutaura vanoshanda mukomiti yevashandi yeZBC vati ndakangotaura chete ini ndasara pabasa kudai ndaenda saka idambudziko rato vakutyisidzirwa tine muteereri mukoma farai vari kuZimbabwe makadii mukoma
makadiwo
ndiri mupenyu ndinoimba kuti mambo onge muchiteererawo hurukuro iri kuitwa iyi panguva yatata takakubatisai parunharei tipei pfungwa dzenyu
kuti hurumende yedu ndiri kuzviringidza zvinhu
asi muri kutaurira pasi tisimudzai izwi zvishoma
ndati hurumende yedu ndiri kutitadzira kuti zvinhu zvifambe zvakanaka vanhu vakanyora constitution vakagadzisa kuti mutemo unge wakanaka asi vari mutemo wekunzo wanga waite kumasuro kuti vanhu vakadzira vakaisa vazhinji vaira vakutambura zvinhuvaa
nhare yenyu iri kuenda ichidzikira zvikuru
vamwe vanga vari pamabasa vanga vabhadhara vamedical aid vamwe vanga vajoina vafinal police kuti vaotova mari muhomwe dzavo futi saka zvinotovatambudza pazvo vekuti vawane kuchengeterwa mari yevachengete yanga vachishanda nguva ese vaotora mari muhomwe dzavo kana kutotengesa zvipfuwo kuti vagabhadhara vamedical aid nekubhadhara mafinal police avanga
vakarevanga vakanyoresa kumakambani yaidambudziko imi muchiri pabasa here
ini ndiripo zvangu pabasa ndikushanda kuprivate kambani
muri kuprivate kambani hamuna tarisiro yekuti rimwe gore munongomukawo mangwana kuseni muchisvikonzi nhasi bvamangodzosera zvitupa zvekambani nemakii nezvese zvamuinazvo
tikutozoona kuti zvinogoongoitika yokuti kambani yana zvotodzika uitoverwa pasi hainifunyatosungirawo
totarisawo marukusheni mamunogarawo mune zviro takamboitawo hurukuru nevamwe vaitaura kuti kana vane dzimba dzanga dzichibhadharwawo marendi aya vari kumiswa mabasa vaakukundikanawo zvakare kubhadhara mitero yedzimba kana marendi dambudziko iri muri kuronawo rakabata sei
riri kubata vanhu vakawanisa kuti munhu kana anga ajairira kuwana mari kuti angori kana angomiswa asingazive kuti ndichaita sei anga akakwereta zvinotanga kutomuneka izvozvo zvanenge vakutoti kana wangaone maschool fees angaita kubhadharwa kana wanga vakwereta unopedzisira vakutorwa kana midziyo nevamwe wokuti munhu abhadhare chikwereti
saka chamungakurudzira chii mapiwa mukana wekutaura pamhepo kudai
kuti bumbiro redu remutemo ndofa kuti rigadziriswe nekuti zvinzvese kuti zvifambe zvotira bumbiro remutemo rakajeka vanhu vakataura asi tiona kuti paministry yejustice haisati yagadzisa mutemo uyu mutemo kuti inake saka rava basa repariamendi opozichena mamembers eopozisheni ngaafacilite kuti mutemo ugadziswe fast track
ndizvozvo
ndo zvatiri kutaura tiri kuno kuti wese
aiwa maita basa zvikuru Gibbs mukoma fara is actually saying the constitution should be harmonized there should be some amendments and if thinks that this may help the situation but he also said he points to the government that the government is to blame for all this.
Mr. Maradade, what can parliament do? You know, we know that you know, parliament and you guys and the executive are not acting on this issue. Maybe there's something that we don't know. The Supreme Court ruling is very suspicious. Why is the government and parliament not acting on this thing?
There's nothing suspicious about the Supreme Court ruling. What the Supreme Court does not make law. They simply interpreted the law. That is the position of the law. It was correctly interpreted by the Supreme Court. But what is then essentially happened is that
the parliament should be then able to amend that part of the law so that workers are protected. But parliament is in recess. Parliament is not sitting until the beginning of September. So there's nothing that parliament can do in the interim and until September. The government...
Can I interview there? Can I say something? Honestly, can you be having some recess when there's a crisis? I think that's absurd, is it?
No. Parliament does not determine when it fits and when it doesn't fit. Because parliament is a calendar. And that calendar, because of that calendar is also determined by government. Where government is in charge of the national affairs. So the state says government owns it. So parliament cannot go and sit if money has not been released to parliament by government. So the principle of separation of powers is actually compromised. Because parliament does not have a funding mechanism of its own. It relies on treasury, which is a department of government. So the principle of separation of powers, as I said, is very compromised. And then what we thought would essentially happen is that the president, because he's empowered by the constitution to invoke his powers to ensure that workers do not, people do not suffer. We, everyone thought the president was going to invoke the presidential powers, which they refused to do. So the only alternative is that parliament must then amend the law. But parliament can only amend the law when it is sitting. And parliament will resume sitting in September because parliament is at the moment in recess.
Thank you very much and stay on the line. I think you can go to Mr. Tambo.
And, Mr. Tambo, ameno kuti ndikabvunza hangu nechivanhu makasununguka here.
Aiwa taura chiro chora nechindevere zvinoita.
Ndimo atoda imi. Ndanichida kubvunza kuti dambudziko riripo vanhu vanongofunga kuti chese chinhu chine chashata ihurumende inenge ichinzi ndo yakanganisa. Asi tiri kuona kuti dambudziko hari kungobata kuhurumende chete. Riri kubatwa nemakambani akazvimirira, makambani ari pasi pehurumende, nepose pangangonzi papa nemushandi, pane kambani isiri kurarama. Takanzwa vamwe vachitaura kuti makambani anga achiri kungochengeta vashandi asi anga ari yatingati bankrupt. Imiwo senyanzvi munyaya dzezvekuongororwa kwemabasa nezvimwe zvakadaro zvemaresearch. Zvii zvamungakurudzira kudai zvaiitwa kugadzisa dambudziko iri pano kuti vanhu vangonongedzana?
Zvamari, unoona chiri kunyanya kunetsa chinhu chimwe chete. Last time government yaamboita inonzi audit ikapa imwe kambani kuti ite audit yekuti kuongororwe kuti vashandi vehurumende vangani. Kwazopedzisira kwabuda mutauro yekuti kwanzi kune vazhinji vari kunzwa kushandira hurumende vari kutambira kasi vari vanhu vasingauyi kumabasa. Ndopakatangira dzimwenda matambudziko atiinawo senyika yezimbabwe raitarika kuti pane mamwe maministries yekuti michero neoneka kufundawo chokwadi tinoita mabasa eika anenge adzisisi ministry yakaita seyeyouth ministry yakaita seyewomen's affairs ministry yakaita seyemaofeterans ministry yakaita seyepsychomotor basa ravo nderei vanhu ava tikada kunyatsokubvunzana chokwadi kuti vanhu vanoita mabasa ei ava vanhu vakushanda mumahofisi aya ngatibvunzanei chokwadi arika then imwe dambudziko yatiri kuita kana kuri mumakambani akazvimirira ogaya makambani mazhinji chokwadi ndechekuti haasi kupefoma hakuna chiri kuumbiwa makambani hakuna chiri kugadzirwa makambani anga angori makambani kuti angova makambani nezita chete anika sazvokuti kuchengeta vashandi apa mukana wauya waudzwa nesupreme court wabva vatorawo kuti vachiudza vashandi kuti ngavachiita sei vachidzokera kudzimba handifungi kuti inini vashandirwi vari kuvenga vashandi vavo kuti vangangovadzinga zvakadaro pasina mari yavanopiwa chinhano zvinhu zviri kuitika munyika kokuti chiro zvavaumba chiro zvavagadzira kana ari mafuta agadzirwa muzimbabwe kana iri sipi agadzirwa muzimbabwe zviri kudhura kuti zvitengeswe kune dzimwe nyika saka zvakureva kuti zvinobva kune dzimwe nyika zvachipa kubva kupfurikidza zvachipa zviri kugadzirwa muzimbabwe zviri kudhura kupfuura zviri kubva kune dzimwe nyika saka zvakureva yatinoti zimbabwe haisina inonzi competitive advantage anika saka zvakureva kuti akui zvatikutenga kubva kune dzimwe nyika zvachipa ndozvaita kuti makambani mazhinji achivhara makambani mazhinji achikoniwa kuramba achichengeta vashandirwi vavo
asi pangatorwa here matanho ekurambidza kuti zvinogadzirwa kunze zvisapinda munyika
zvinhu zvatingaita kasekutanga ndiyo kuti hazviita isizi kuitika ngatikangei taona kuti isu sitogona here kuumba zvinhu zvachona izvozvo zvatoti tichavhara kuti zvisaitika chekutanga pane zvinhu zvakaita semagroceries ekuti iko zvino unoona Zimbabwe tichita kuimporta zvinhu zvakaita sematoothpick chokwadi chokwadi tingatenga matoothpick kubva kuchina here tinogona kugadzira tega here muno munyika yezimbabwe arika zvinhu zvakaita sezvimwe zvatinorima vanhu vakapuwa mapurazi vanhu ngavarime mapurazi umu hatingatengi huku kubva kunana Brazil hatingatengi isusu zvimwe zvinhu kubva kunyika dzakawanda wanda ivo vanhu vakapuwa mapurazi ndo zvimwe zvezvinhu patingaganhura kuti ngatigadzirisei tiumbei zvedu tega muno senyika yezimbabwe kachikuru ndezvekuti ngatitarirei zviri kuitira kuti zvinhu zviri kugadzirwa muzimbabwe zvidhure chii chekutanga magetsi edu ezimbabwe anodhura ndochekutanga zvakare magetsi anogara achienda nguva nenguva ogara magetsi achienda saka zvinoreva kuti kune anoenga ane mari aida kubva kunze kwenyika achizoita kambani yake muno muzimbabwe anoona kuti magetsi anoshanda oshanda mamwe maawas achakwanisa kushanda kuti magetsi aenda ndozvimwe zvinhu zviri kutikanganisa muzimbabwe kuno unozova neinonzi cost of credit zvinodhura kuti munhu ari kuita bhizinesi muzimbabwe awane chikwereti kubhangi tarirai ngatipei mufananidzo iye zvino ane bhizinesi muzimbabwe kana akada kutora loan kubhengi hawani loan anokwanisa kuwana iri anything less than 18% pagore interest asi munhu ari kuita bhizinesi kusouth africa yake interest inenge iri around 4-5% pagore zvimwe zvakarachizoipiwa loan iyi kwenguva yakati rebei tozotarira nyaya dzakaita senrz kudonha kwaita nrz kwakureva isusu kuti vanoda kusenga nhombi dzinorema angange ari marasha kana kuti zvimwe zvinhu zvakadaro akushandisa atoti magonyeti hachakwanisi kushandisa chitima ndozvo zvimwe zvaita kuti yatinoti cost of doing business ive very high muzimbabwe then chimwe chiri kutikanganisa muzimbabwe mitemo yatiri kuisa pane mutemo wakaita seindigenization mutemo uyu hauna kuipa kasi tatinokanganisa ndechekuti vanhu havachazivi chokwadi chekuti unorevei mutemo uya nekuti pane dzimwe nguva vamwe vanokudza kuti no chiyatora 51% yekambani yako vamwe vozobuda mumwe minista anenge apinzwawo achiri kufarisa kuti iye kwatichatora 90% yebhizinesi rako ndozve zvimwe zvemitemo inofanira kugadziriswa kuitira tiwane chinonzi foreign direct investment muzimbabwe uye zvakare vanhu vave nekugutsikana kuti vakaunza mari yavo muzimbabwe havasi kuzomuka kutorerwa mari iyi kana kutorerwa mabhizinesi avo nyaya dzakaita ndozvandoona inini kunge zvikaga
Thank you so much. He explained quite a lot. And I think the most important issue that he raised is the importation of almost everything, including chicken that we can rear in Zimbabwe, even toothpicks.
Yeah.
When we were growing up, we used to use grass for toothpicks.
That's right. Yeah.
That's a local product.
Maybe there's no grass anymore, right?
We don't know, but how can you import toothpick?
Yeah, that's shocking.
Yes,
that's
and the chicken... And those that are produced on manufactured in Zimbabwe, he says they are too expensive, and Zimbabwe lacks competition with the outside world. And I think that's a very good
point. Mr. Maridate, your last word, just 1 minute.
Yeah, well, I think my last word is that I agree with everything that the last speaker said. I mean, he spoke about a lot of things why the economy is not performing, and as I say. It's because of bad policies. Bad political policies have negative, have a very bad impact on economic policies, and it is very bad for the economy. We must have a people-centered government, a people-centered political party that runs government, which puts in place policies that are friendly to international investors. What Zimbabwe needs is foreign direct investment. Without foreign direct investment, we can talk all night and nothing will change. We need policies that are friendly to people that have money coming from outside. We need to repeal some laws like the indigenous law, which tells people that the moment you land in Zimbabwe with your money, then 51% is owned by a local person. And you know, it's not local person. It's just a few individuals that are getting rich out of
Thank you. Country. Thank you, Mr. Maridate. Yeah. Time is out. I think you still remember when you were a broadcaster. This was the most difficult moment, right? To tell somebody, you know, time is out. Sorry, we're out of time. We have to leave it there. We thank our guests this evening, Mr. Foster Tongozi, Secretary General of the Zimbabwe Union of Journalists, Mr. Washington Mehlomakulu, Independent Political and Economic Commentator, Mr. Butler Tambo, a policy researcher at the Public Policy Research Institute of Zimbabwe. Signing off is Gibbs Dube in Washington, D.C.
Thanks so also to our listeners who called in, Gibbs, mm-hmm. and those who were about to call, but you cut them out.
Because of the time.
Thank you so much. This is Jonga Kandemiri.
Goodbye, Zimbabwe.